Azusa. The national chairman of our great party, Dr. Potofi. Even at this stage, we want to recognize your tireless contribution to our great party and to assure you of a fitting place after today serving the party as its council of elders. Former President Jerry John Rawlings, founder of our party, President of our Republic, today as a country, we celebrate deeper democratic values, strengthen democratic institutions. We owe it to you under the Fourth Republic for ushering in multi-party constitutional democracy in Ghana. And indeed, the most enduring multi-party constitutional democracy in our country's history. Former President John Dramani Mahama, the memories of your service to our republic as MP, Minister, Vice President and President is still fresh in the memory of many Ghanaians and us all. You have made a remarkable contribution to the social, economic and political development of our country. I recognize you. The Speaker of Parliament, former, he has led the party in many capacities and served as well as leader in the House, assisting at majority and minority level and serving as the third most important gentleman of our republic. First Deputy Speaker, Honorable Bagbin, one of the longest serving members of parliament, members of the NDC Council of Elders, colleague members of parliament and colleagues in leadership, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen of the NDC. We are here today, the determined moments of history. Today is our first large gathering to select leaders for our party's forward march into victory 2020. Allah Ta'ala will guide us through and will see us through to elect leaders with integrity, leaders with will, leaders who will mobilize the grassroots of our party and work for the irresistible return of the National Democratic Government. We are here today, and let me urge you all, delegates, today let's close the book on the bleeding wounds of 2016. Let us all resolve and commit ourselves to be guided by the lessons of the consequential defeat of 2016 and march forward in unity. I therefore couldn't agree with the team, together we win. Unity, in unity together, victory 2020. The NDC must lead the shining promise of tomorrow. To do so, we cannot continue to turn our back to lamentations of 2016 and periods beyond. The future is ours. Let's be guided by the past and let the past guide us to govern well and govern differently, given the opportunity as a political party. Chairman and distinguished delegates, I am happy to note that thanks to you and the grassroots of our party, we have 106 representatives in parliament who are ably represented here. Of them, we have 13 female members of parliament. I want to use this opportunity to appeal to the leadership of the party to preserve and protect the seats of the female MPs and to work to increase the number of women MPs in parliament on the ticket of the National Democratic Congress. For they understand some of the issues that affect population and nutrition and can serve us all. Chairman and distinguished delegates, we have in the last 22 months at least assisted President Nana Addoudankwa to compose in history. He has beaten the Guinness Book of Record, the largest size of government and an elephant size of government of 110 ministers. That certainly cannot be a reduction on the public purse. We have assisted the President as Parliament and as members of Parliament to pass very important legislations, namely the Development Authorities of Northern Development, Coastal Development and Middle Development. Sad and regrettably, these development authorities are now being run from the Flagstaff House and denied resources to contribute to the development of those areas. They have only become bureaucratic creations of the Nana Akufo-Addo government. Chairman and distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we also, as a parliament, have supported the president as we should do in establishing the office of special prosecutor. To quote the president, he says it's a novelty and a watershed. Let me remind President Nana Addoudankwa that under President Rawlings in the 1980s, there was office of the special prosecutor and there was Justice Amanimoni and others appointed to it. We may want to improve upon it and assure him of our common quest to combat corruption, to fight economic graft and graft in our country, and to expose it. While he gives a stick to us, he should not give a broom to ruling members of his party. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we are, as a party, not at crossroads. I am very certain and optimistic of the future prospects of our party, and I'm very optimistic that we will constitute government January 2021. What we need to do is to work together in unity to heal the wounds of the past and the rule and the biblical saying that love your neighbor like thyself. Do not injure your neighbor. No member of the NDC should be happy causing any injury to your neighbor, a member of our great party. We have done our utmost best. And Mr. Chairman, let me now conclude. Since this is a national platform, I'll respond to just two policy issues. A few days ago, Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia, supported by Ken Oforiatta, sought to define social intervention. Those of you who have phones in your hand, you can Google Wikipedia definition of social intervention. And to quote the Minister of Finance, he says that NDC has no social intervention. Yet, we contributed to quality education in the country, we contributed to healthcare delivery, and we contributed to reducing infant and child mortality. Indeed, in 2015, Ghana, under President Mahama, was awarded by the UN for having poverty. Yet a party and a government which have poverty did not contribute any way to the social intervention of our country. Maybe Dr. Bawumia and Honorable Ken Oforiatta must go to the Thesaurus Dictionary to look for a new, different definition of social intervention. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I can only wish our aspirants very, very well. And to assure you that when you build a house with saliva, the house collapses with dew. The MPP house will collapse, and it will collapse because it was built on saliva. Today, we are told one district, one factory, 79, zero for Upper East Region in 2019 budget. Yet in 2018, it was 131, they promised. They said 109 will be ready. Where are they? We will, as a parliamentary minority, continue to exercise oversight and to demand increased transparency and accountability.